Alright, so for today's video, we're going to take a look at the new Battle Pass and everything it has to offer. But before we take a look at it, I did want to go over some new information in regards to Save the World. So I guess the first thing I want to point out is that we did get some new information in regards to the new Venture Zone. According to some leaks that I found on Twitter, it's going to be located in the Hexylvania biome, which is the Halloween biome. The Haunted Hotel could also make a return to the Season 2 Venture Zone. I believe it was part of the Fort Nightmares questline last year. And the Shady Acres or Swamp biome could also be included in the new Hexylvania Venture Zone. And here's a couple of other screenshots that were leaked. As you can tell, it looks like Vlad's gonna be returning, which was the Taker boss that we had to fight in previous Fort Nightmares events. But that was the first thing I wanted to point out. Second thing I want to go over are the new modifiers you can expect to see in the new Hexylvania Venture Zone. One of them is called Short Range, and this modifier makes enemies close to a player or defender suffer more damage, and those that are further away will suffer less. Also, all enemies will have a chance to drop a healing pickup when they're eliminated. And here's what that healing pickup supposedly looks like. So that's one of the new modifiers. The other one's called Acid Rain. And for this one, you're gonna have to stay undercover because heroes will suffer damage over time when they're not under a roof. So it sounds like you may either have to like constantly build in order to avoid taking damage, or you're gonna have to find ways to constantly heal yourself. So with that being said, you're probably gonna wanna use heroes that increase your health, like Parasaur Jess, Triceraops, Birthday Jonesy. You could also use Crossbones Barrett in order to get those coconuts. I feel like Bladebeard Stash is a good team perk to use for this modifier, because that also gives you coconuts. You can also use weapons like the Ginger Blaster, the Candy Corn, or melee weapons that have Life Leech, because those weapons can help you get your health back. So those are the two modifiers that you're gonna see in the new Hexylvania Venture Zone. And again, the current Venture Zone is supposed to end on September 4th, so I assume that's when the new one's going to begin. And here's a list of potential rewards that you may see with the next Venture Zone. As you can tell, it looks very similar to the rewards that we get this time around. It also looks like it requires almost the same amount of XP. One thing I should point out is that we may also get a quest line that may provide some superchargers. So these may not be the only rewards, but when it comes to your venture level rewards, they look very similar to the ones that we have now. And that's everything I could find in regards to the new Venture Zone. Also, it looks like the new Scrapper Samurai Hero will be a part of a new starter pack. I did check the store to see if it was available, but it's not available yet. But it looks like he will be added sometime during the next Venture Zone. As you can tell with this image, it looks like it's going to come with a helmet, as well as a back bling, 1000 V-Bucks, some X-ray tickets, which can be used to open X-ray llamas, as well as a spear. So with Metal Team Leader, we got the Papa Bear SMG, but with the Scrapper Samurai, you're gonna get a spear. And the last thing I wanna go over are the changes made to power levels. Now, I'm not sure if this is a visual bug or if it's intended, because Epic hasn't mentioned it, but when you log in, you'll notice that your power level has decreased a little bit. We're still 131, but we're not close to 132 like we were. And when you group up with other max level players, it increases your overall power level to 211. And again, I'm not sure if this is a visual bug or not, but we went ahead and loaded in a 4x mission, and the husks that spawned in on this encampment were power level 211. And I also heard that the husk power level can go up to 400 on endurance. So apparently there's been some changes made to power levels, or like I said, it could be a visual bug. We don't really know because Epic hasn't said anything about it yet. But that was another thing I wanted to point out. And like they mentioned in last week's home base status report, the hot mix will be available this Friday in the event store, and you'll be able to earn this loading screen from the new Hit the Road questline, which should be available this Friday. Also, here's a list of event heroes you can now research. You may have noticed Art Deco has been added to that list, so you'll no longer need to use your hero vouchers to get Art Deco heroes, as well as the rest of these event heroes. And I'll leave a link to all of the Twitter sources and where I found this list in the description. So that's pretty much everything we know in regards to Save the World. And like I said earlier, I also wanted to show everything you can get from the new Battle Pass. And we're actually going to go ahead and get the Battle Bundle since we have enough V-Bucks for it. So I'm just going to go ahead and scroll through the first 26 levels. It's like we got Thor at the first level. We also got the Bifrost Glow, which I do remember seeing in the Marvel movies. We also got a new spray, as well as Thor's cloak, and a new glider, as well as a banner. Looks like there's also some challenges for Thor's hammer. We also got a loading screen, as well as a wrap. We also got another style for our glider, as well as an emoticon. Oh, so it looks like you can use this hammer as a glider as well. There's also some challenges for Thor once you reach level 15. We also got the She-Hulk weapon skin, as well as the She-Hulk spray. We also got Wars Horizon music, and we will check this out here in a second. As well as another loading screen with Iceman. I think that's Galactus in the background. There's another She-Hulk style for the glider. You also got the Jennifer Walters outfit, which I believe is an edit style for She-Hulk. You also got Scales of Justice, back bling, as well as another banner. We also got the Hammers of Justice harvesting tools, 400 V-Bucks. And that's everything you'll get from the battle bundle or after you reach level 26. I also want to check out everything else we can get from the battle pass real quick. All right, so at level 27, we got another loading screen, another emoticon that looks like She-Hulk's arm. So once you reach level 29 and complete Jennifer Walters' Awakening Challenges, you'll unlock this Gamma Overload built-in emote that makes you transform into the She-Hulk. See, there's a new contrail at level 30, some V-Bucks at 31. You also have the little baby Groot back bling at level 32. There's also a new skin called Sap at 33, a new spray at 34. There's also some more music at 35. And here's what that music sounds like. Speaking of which, here's what the Wars Horizon music sounds like. Couldn't hear it earlier when we got the battle bundle. There's also a new Groot banner, as well as a Groot harvesting tool. And it looks like there are some different styles for it. You'll be able to get Groot at level 38, as well as a Groot style for your glider at 39. There's also a Grootling emoticon at 40, some V-Bucks at 41. You also get the Root Wing glider at 42. There's a new Rocket Blaster spray at 43, a new loading screen for 44. At 45, you'll get the Raccoon banner. And it looks like him and Groot have a built-in emote. You'll unlock this once you reach 46 and complete the Groot Awakening challenges. At 47, you'll get some more V-Bucks. A cloud burst weapon skin at 48, and you can actually see the rain falling on that weapon skin. There's also a storm warning emoticon, as well as the storms strike contrail. You also got the storm banner, some more V-Bucks, and you also get the storm outfit at level 53. At 54, you'll get the storm edit style for your glider. You also get the storm harvesting tool at 55. There's a loading screen at 56. You'll get the Storm Glider at 57. There's a Storm Spray at 58. You'll get some more V-Bucks at level 59. And once you reach level 60 and complete the Storm Awakening challenges, you'll get this Gale Force built-in emote. See, at 61, we get some more music. Let's go ahead and listen to it real quick. At 62, you get the Doom Juice emoticon. That Doom Juice. At 63, you'll get the Dr. Doom banner. You get the Staff of Doom harvesting tool at 64. Oh, I think it has multiple faces on it. At 65, you'll get some more V-Bucks. You'll get the Arcane Steel weapon skin at 66. And you get Dr. Doom at 67. At 68, you'll get this Pimp Cup. At 69, you'll get the Dr. Doom style for your glider. At 70, you'll get some more V-Bucks. At 71, you'll get the Dr. Doom glider. At 72, you'll get this loading screen. 73, you'll get these contrails. Once you reach level 74 and complete the Dr. Doom challenges, you'll unlock this built-in emote, which looks really cool, in my opinion. Looks like he's sitting on a throne. At level 75, you'll get the Mystique style for your glider. At 76, you'll get the Mystique emoticon. You get another banner at 77, some more V-Bucks at 78. Another loading screen at 79, and you'll get Mystique at level 80. At 81, we get the Mystique's skull back bling. At 82, we get the Mystique spray. We get Mystique's harvesting tools at 83, and there are different styles for this one. We'll get this contrail at 84. Here's the weapon skin we'll get at 85. It looks like it appears and then disappears. Once you reach 86 and complete Mystique's challenges, you'll get her shapeshifter built-in emote. So that's going to allow you to transform and change skins. At 87, we get this Iron Man loading screen. 88, you get some more V-Bucks. At 89, we get the Iron Man backplate. All the little guns come out. Okay. So there's what the back bling looks like. You also get the Iron Man banner at 90, the Iron Man wrap at 91. At 92, you get some more V-Bucks. At 93, you're going to get Tony Stark. At 94, you'll get the Iron Man style for your glider. At 95, you get the Iron Man spray. At 96, you get the Mark 85 Energy Blade Harvesting Tool. At 97, you'll get the Iron Man emoticon. At 98, you'll get the Mark 90 Flight Pack glider. And there's what the glider looks like. At 99, you'll get some more V-Bucks. And once you reach level 100 and complete Tony Stark Awakening challenges, you'll unlock the built-in suit-up Iron Man emote. Let's go check the emote one more time. Basically makes you transform into Iron Man. And those are all of the rewards between level 1 and 100. Apparently, there are some more rewards that you can earn, but I don't think they're available yet, or at least not all of them. There's a Wolverine spray, as well as a loading screen. This loading screen is going to unlock in 7 days. There's also a Wolverine back bling that will unlock in 14 days. There's a Wolverine wrap that will unlock in 3 weeks. There's also a Wolverine style for your glider. And you can unlock Wolverine in 35 days. So he's not going to be available yet, but he will be available soon. There's also a Wolverine emoticon, as well as a Wolverine banner. And there's also a Wolverine built-in emote that'll make his claws come out. And there's also some weekly challenge rewards that'll help you get an extra style for Jennifer, as well as an extra style for Storm. There's also an extra style for Wolverine. And there's one for Dr. Doom as well. And there's another style for Mystique. And is that everything? Okay, I think that's everything in regards to the Battle Pass. You'll be able to access your Wolverine challenges from there. So I guess it's Wolverine sort of going to be like Deadpool was, where you have to do like certain challenges every week. I should also point out that there may be some edit styles I wasn't able to show that you'll be able to earn this season. And there's also a couple of other skins, which I'm not exactly sure how you'll be able to get them, but here are a couple of other skins you can get from this season as well. And I guess the last thing we'll do is check out the item shop. I don't think there was anything new other than the battle passes and the battle bundle. Yeah, I don't think anything new was added. But that sums up everything I wanted to go over for this one. Let me know what you all think about the new battle pass and all of the skins that came with it. Also, let me know what you think about the new weapon wraps and back blings, as well as the contrails and gliders. And let me know what y'all think about the Hexylvania map returning for the next Venture Zone. So since we didn't really get anything new this week in Save the World, I think we'll go ahead and stream some VR tonight, check out the new map, the new places of interest, and we'll try to unlock some of these new skins. Anyways, that's everything I'm gonna go over for this one. I hope y'all found the video useful, and thanks for watching.